Here's another Kick Ash Rock on the Range moment, brought to you by Vapor Station. Kicking ash every day.
Your Rock Station 99.7 The Blitz. Hello, it is Hales broadcasting live from Rock on the Range 2016. And I am joined right now by a band who I've been following for so long and I'm so excited to have here at Rock on the Range. Between the Baird and me, Paul Wagner. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having me.
How does it feel to be at Rock on the Range for you?
It's overwhelming. Festivals in general are pretty overwhelming for bands like us because we're so used to just sort of playing small clubs and stuff. But we've gotten used to it over the years, embracing the magnitude of it, I guess. There's a lot of people here. There's a lot of bands here.
There's a lot of diversity.
That was the next thing I was going to say. So, you just see, like, even just sort of drive pulling into the place, like looking at all the different types of people that are here, and you're like, wow. We don't see people like that at our shows or whatever. So it's we've learned to sort of embrace the weirdness and the discomfort for us.
Like, which is good, yeah.
Yeah, because, you know, we're a band that we like to sort of push ourselves out of the realm of comfort, you know.
Very out of the ordinary, yes.
Very out of the ordinary. So we're stoked to be here. And, it's like the 10th anniversary or whatever. So it's cool to be a part of it, you know. And
Well, that was one of my favorite things about seeing you guys on the lineup is that it's the 10-year anniversary, and I feel like every year they've gotten better about diversifying the metal that they have here.
Yeah.
So to see a band like you guys, who radio listeners might not know, have like 10-minute-long progressive metal tracks.
Yeah.
So to have you guys on here doing a festival set, which is much shorter than I'm sure you're used to.
Of course, yeah.
How do you approach that going into the festival scene?
We get a 30-minute set.
Yeah.
So that is very restrictive.
Do you play more than two songs?
We're playing four today.
Okay, good.
It's a miracle we're able to play four. But yeah, we were just talking to another guy about, like, it is a challenge to pick the right set to play. Because, you know, we want to present ourselves as authentically as possible. So, we want people to say, oh, this band sounds like this, and it be accurate. But at the same time, it is a festival. You're trying to sort of, you want people to like it, you know what I mean? So we don't want to go up there and play like a 20-minute long epic song that meanders here and there, you know.
Absolutely.
We want to make it as concise enough to where people can enjoy it, you know.
And I had a similar conversation last year with Periphery because
they're
very similar in that they have very lengthy songs. They're kind of all over the place. Like, you've got some stuff that's a little lighter for this kind of crowd and then stuff that's heavier, but this crowd would also really like.
Right.
So.
And there's a certain element of, like, some of our stuff, some of the more dynamically written songs, like some of the slower or softer parts don't really translate well in this type of environment because you're outside, the sound is not as good. We take that all into consideration when we're trying to decide what songs to play.
Yeah.
You know, for sure.
And I will talk about the new album, Coma Ecliptic, as well. Awesome. You guys have been touring like crazy on this album. I mean, you tour a lot already, but I feel like I've seen more and more tours on this album than I have for past ones. So how has it all been, and do you like that, like, always on tour mentality?
Well, it's been great, you know. I mean, we're certainly very fortunate to still be able to do this after all these years and tour and, you know, make a living at it. So, the response has been great to the new record. So the touring cycle's gone very well. We've done some really cool tours. We've toured with some really cool bands. So we're definitely very happy with that. As you get older, it gets a little harder to be away from your family and all that stuff. And, you know, living on a bus that smells like farts and feet.
Smells,
you know?
Like dude.
Yeah, smell like dude. Smells like dude. That doesn't get any better as with time. You know, you're like, oh, God, get me out of here. But at the same time, we love doing what we do. There's an immediate reward to playing live shows and seeing people interact with the songs that you conjured up out of thin air, you know. Like, all those little things that really make you appreciate what you do.
Yeah.
But, you know, we try to not tour quite as much as we did when we were younger just because it is a little harder. You know, some guys have kids. Some guys are married.
It's also physically harder as you get older.
It's physically harder, You know, it's just more taxing on your body, so it's tough. But all that being said, I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world, you know. If it's time to go on tour, I'm ready to – I'll pack my bag and go in a heartbeat. Yep.
And last time I talked to you, Coma Ecliptic was still fairly new. So how has it been, like, since then? Like, how's the reception been going this past year?
It's been great, you know. Like, I mean – I think we're going to do a tour this fall with the Devin Townsend Project, which was just recently announced a couple days ago. And we're going to play the whole record. So that'll be the ultimate test to see how people are digging the new album.
Every song on
We've been real pleased with how it's gone over. You know, I mean, we love that album. We're very proud of it. but it's different. You know, we're always, we're a band that kind of prides ourselves on sort of trying to push the envelope every time and do something different every time to challenge ourselves, to challenge our fans. And, you know, we never know if it's going to, if it's going to sink or float, you know what I mean? But it seems to be floating at the moment. You know,
for
people
sure.
seem to be digging it. So, yeah, we're stoked.
Well, I'm happy for you guys to see that it is doing so well, because it's
you.
An amazing record, and
awesome.
I
Thank
love
you
it.
So
and
much.
As much as I love Coma Ecliptic and Between the Buried and Me, there are a lot of other side projects that all of the members have going on. You've got Tommy's solo stuff. I know Dan Briggs. I saw
Dan's
him with
Tree Escapes.
Yeah. Not Tree Escopes, Tree Escapes.
Well, that's just one. He probably has a band
he's
called
got
Tree Escopes, too.
He's making
a
side project off of Tree Escapes called Tree Escopes.
Yeah.
So how are they still working on those projects while you're still doing Between the Buried and Me? Because we haven't seen anything solo from everybody else in a while.
Dan's always doing something.
Oh,
so
okay.
if he's not in Between the Buried and Me land, he's in Tree Escapes land or Orbs land.
Yeah.
He's, he has a project called Nova Collective with some of the guys from the band Haken in England. That's sort of a transcontinental project that he's doing.
Okay.
So he's always doing something musically.
Yeah.
Never really at the same time as BT BAM stuff is going on, but he's always doing something.
Yeah.
Tommy's the same way. I mean, he's always working on something, you know, musically, if he's not doing the Between the Buried and Me. For me, I've never had a side project. Everything I write musically, I always want it to be BT BAM anyway.
Yeah.
I'm going to try to find a way to get it in there, so to speak.
Have you ever thought about branching out and maybe doing, like, with other band members of other bands kind of thing?
I thought about it, but again, I think when I write a piece of music that I'm really proud of, it's hard for me to want to not want it to be a BT BAM
to
song.
To want to detach,
you know what I mean?
It, yeah.
I'm that's kind of like my baby. I've been in it since the beginning, and that's where I want, like, my musical creativity is fully devoted to that. So yeah, my side hustle is coffee.
I was gonna say we talked a little bit last time I talked to you about your coffee business.
Yeah.
So
and that keeps me, I think that keeps music fun for me.
Yeah.
I don't want to be so absorbed into music where it becomes like a chore, you know, or a job to write music. I want it to still be fun and fresh for me. So
absolutely.
Anything else I do in life will probably be tangential. If I can use a weird word.
A very big word. I appreciate that. Yes.
So
vocabulary.
It'll be maybe be related to music, but it'll be something a little different than actually just writing music and being in a band, you know.
I like it. Well, I'm glad the coffee thing is going well still.
It's going.
I'm glad all the music is resonating. I'm very excited to see you guys today. You hit the stage 3, I believe, right?
Yes, you're correct.
Since they don't actually have names, just number 3.
Yeah, or C. I've heard people call it
A, B, or
C. Stage.
Yeah, whatever it's called. Stage 3, the one that's over here.
The little one.
Yeah, the one that's like right outside of our tent at 5:35 today. So if you are going to come down to Rock on the Range, make sure you do not miss Between the Buried and Me. I think I've seen you guys 7 times now, so I can vouch for you guys
awesome,
as being awesome.
You.
So Between the Buried and Me again, Paul Wagner, new album Coma Ecliptic is out now. Go get it. And it is Hales broadcasting live from Rock on the Range for your Rock Station 99.7 The Blitz.